Sometimes.
The rule of thumb I like to, I usually do only 1 foot for a spider guard, 1 foot lobster, but they're all interconnected. Because I'm here, this is collar and sleeve. I want to tilt them to my right here, okay? Because this arm is exposed for a lasso, okay? So as he wants to posture up and pull this arm back, okay, I can bring this in for a lasso, and I can get a spider right there. Okay, you can't really do double lasso, or if you do, you're just stuck, okay? So from here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to undo the lasso, okay, and I have a spider guard right here, because I can begin to shift my hips here and begin to rotate them up out. But let's say he stepped out or whatever it may be, and I grab this collar right here, okay? And you have, it's like a one-legged spider guard right here. Yeah. He's posturing up, and oftentimes, wants to block that leg from coming over for that arm up there.
Yeah.
So you grab right here, one, two,
tap,
and three. So this foot is controlling his bicep, and I'm constantly creating tension. This leg is never locked, okay? It's springy, okay? Yeah, because what he doesn't want is he doesn't want me just to get an arm like this way here, okay? So oftentimes they defend that against that leg coming in. Yes, right here, okay? And now from here, you're going to cut that tricep elbow, kick it off here, go right here. It doesn't feel like an arm lock until this
arm
right here.
Tap.
And it's really super tight right in there. It's called the semi-stroke. So you can start with a one-legged spider here, okay? Because this is also spider guard here, 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 but I don't like double spider here. So here, and I had it on the collar. Because even if he stands up, look, I can also begin to look. Push his leg away here. And you have triangles here. You also have single leg X entry here. But he stands up. Yeah, that stuff right there. But now, try. Same thing. Collar, sleeve, pull the hips, feet on the hips, pull back to center, then all the way across, drop that hand on the mat, to try to get the lasso here, get the spider, undo it, and you can, okay, try to get this leg back in action, of course, getting out here, look, one, through here, use a lock area,
tap.
This to get stuck in an arm, but you get the tricep, kick it off here and right
tap
there. Here you have almost a lot of strength. Does that make sense, guys? So you can also start right here. Okay. Remember, for spider guard, I need to have tension. So I control that arm and I keep it bent and I keep it in the bicep, and you need a monkey part of your feet because it makes a big difference here. So as we're here, and I keep moving my hip out. One, two, one, two, and
tap.
Because you can't rotate and keep your left hand on the elbow. Okay, because if I remove it, he'll be able to at least rotate it, and then you have to go to a normal flat. Here, I'm just cupping his elbow and pinching my elbow.
So it's actually covering the elbow joint.
Yes. Yeah, literally. So it's harder for him to try to rotate it on.
I can't.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then I'll let him rotate. So I'm holding it like a seat right here. So you can just start right here. Because look, if you're sitting here and playing open guard here and he begins to pass, there's your one-legged spider here. See how much hip movement there is, but this is pulling with just four fingers here. Pulling here, no thumb. And pushing here. So maybe sweep from here, this way here, back here. One. Put the jogo quad on.
Tap.
Let's try it. One, two, three.